It's Vicky, and welcome back. I have in front of me composition notebooks, and I was working on a different video for Mind the Gap, but I thought, you know what? I've been doing back to school shopping because it's end of July, and my kids start seeing all the supplies, and then they start getting nervous and worried that everything's going to get sold out that they want. So we've been trickling in school supplies. And it's no secret that it's my most favorite time of year as well. I love back to school supply shopping. And while doing so, I had an idea and I thought I would share it with all of you. And so that's why I veered away from the original path. Don't worry, I will come back to it. But I want to talk about composition notebooks because I feel like these guys, people get excited about them and then they banish them. But I feel like there's a cult following for composition notebooks. I do. So we're going to talk about them. We're going to talk about filling them up and ways to fill them up because there are so many of them around. And I think this is the best time of year to pick up and stock up on them. It's my absolute favorite time
of
year to do
that. So I
actually was going to go run up and grab my Linda Berry book because if you ever need inspiration for a composition notebook, Linda Berry's Accidental Notes of a Professor book is my all-time favorite. It's actually currently on my nightstand. I look at that book all the time. It's like always on my nightstand. I love that book a lot. I find it extremely, extremely inspirational when it comes to really any notebook, but especially composition.
I just went ahead and grabbed the one that I have down here. I have I have three of her books.
This one is What It Is. The Formless Thing, which Give Things For, from Linda Berry. She is a professor at, I think, University of Madison, Wisconsin. And I follow her on YouTube, and I also follow her on social media, and she has her students fill in composition notebook pages. And I just love it. I love how she does it. It's so inspirational to see this. It's simple enough that I think most of us can do it. And I truly have her book up on my nightstand because it just, I don't know, it helps me to feel inspired when I feel in a slump. So the reason I bring up compositional books again is because it's the time of year to buy. They're relatively inexpensive. And because we're working on Minding the Gap, it's really, we're focused on the exercise of filling in pages, backfilling pages. And you need ideas for doing that. You need inspiration for doing that. And so I'm hoping to cover that in this video. So I have several different kinds of composition notebooks, including those little itty bitty mini ones. I didn't bring those out because I know you guys know what those are, but they're really like tiny ones. I got these composition notebooks actually a little while back. So sometimes people will sell, it's like a, what's the right word to use? I've seen people share tutorials on this to use this as a way to make extra cash on Amazon. So you can go to, like, I think it's KDP maybe on Amazon, where you can publish your own books and people will actually go ahead and make composition notebooks with covers, you know, that you can make whatever. This is Crafty Girl Journals. So people will go on there and then as you order, Amazon will print them and send them out to people. It's really smart. It's cute. And I loved the fact that these were themed Halloween. Obviously, I love Halloween or fall, whatever. For me, I personally really liked the way that the lines were set up in here. So it was a little less of that traditional kind of formatting. And then there is no, like what you would find in a traditional composition notebook, on the front and the back pages. Aside from the barcode, and then it's from Crafty Girl Journals. This year, and I'm going to bring you along with it, doing it. I just haven't decided in which size I want to work on, but I want to document all of my current like DIY projects and things that I want to work on for my fall and Halloween projects. I love them. And I feel like I do a lot of DIYs. I do a ton of stuff. I do a ton of decorating and it's kind of like everywhere, which I don't necessarily mind, but I also want to have like a space where I have dedicated to doing that. And so I'm going to go through and kind of decide and set that up. We'll kind of get that going because I really want to get that. I've already done my first DIY for the year for Halloween. I'll try and insert an image here for you guys. And then if you follow me on Instagram, you would have seen my reel for it as well. I'll try and pop it in here for you guys. So these guys are really great. again, look on Amazon because you will find them. And if you just type into Amazon, like Halloween composition notebook, whatever, you should be able to find them on there. I have this one, and then I have one more in here, this one here. They are a little bit shorter than a traditional composition notebook. So just to show you, they're a little bit on the shorter side, which is cute because they're a little bit like more square, which I love. So they're 9 3/4 by 7 1/2 inches. This has like a matte cover. So this one has like a gloss. This one's a matte one. I love this pattern. It reminds me of the Mackenzie Child, and I love Mackenzie Child. This has the same format. It's from, I believe, the same Crafty Girl Journals. I want to say it's from her also. Yep. And in this one, you can see, again, there's nothing on the back pages. The lines are a little bit more of a muted gray. Really, really pretty. And I really, really like them. So those are the two that I have there. When it comes to back to school shopping, though, when I see like this, like a vinyl-ish maybe cover, I love these. And grid is my jam. I love a grid notebook. It's my number one favorite. If you guys are true OGs and you remember my Miguel Ruiz notebooks where I started the Fobonichis, you know this is the kind of paper that it had inside. It's my all-time favorite kind of paper. I still to this day love it. It just helps me with spacing of letters and writing and drawing and all that kind of jazz. So whenever I find these, I pick these up. I love the ruled ones. I think I have a few on my shelf. My kids try and steal these, but I have a few of those. This one's also a graph one. It just has a more traditional cover, like the marble cover. But when I see graph, you guys, I grab a lot of these because I love them. And then I also love, I'll show you guys this one here. And I haven't seen this one. I think I got this one actually, where did I get this? Was this Dollar Tree? Dollar Tree actually has really good ones too. And this might actually be the Dollar Tree one. Oh no, this is Staples. Sorry. Staples has really good ones too. This one's made in Egypt. But you can see it's got that like slick kind of cover. I love that it's pink. And it kind of strays away from your like super traditional notebooks. So, and I love like the floppiness of them. These really do it for me. So those are kind of the styles I look for when I'm going to purchase them. Then, in more recent years, we've been seeing these half composition notebooks. I've only really seen these at Walmart, and this whole stack of these was $4.98, 100% worth it, in my opinion. But there have been years in the past years where I have been unable to find them. And so what I did was I just took composition notebooks and went to Staples and had them cut it down. Now, the girl who did it for me actually, she couldn't figure out how to do a half cut. And so she ended up cutting them and kind of did some a little bit on the wonky side, which is totally okay. It didn't bother me. She felt really ashamed by it, but I wasn't upset at all. And so I've had my own, and my kids have actually taken some, and they love them as well. I can see the benefits and the perks of having half composition notebooks for as a teacher. I feel like these are so great as a teacher. But that means that they're really great for us as well, for people who like to journal, plan. These would be really wonderful if you're someone who has a hard time sticking to one journal or one notebook, one planner for the whole year, because you can basically go in here for even like a month and use it for a month, or you can use it for a half year, whatever, however you want to set it up. And there's so many great and creative ways to go about using them. I will show you a couple of different ideas that I've done, and I like decorating the covers of them. So for these, what I did was I created like a daily journal out of one of them. I put stickers in here that I believe are from Courtney, Little Raven Ink, and then these were mine. Probably some Amazon ones on there as well. And then I just took packaging tape and taped over the top. You can also Mod Podge. You can do all kinds of fun stuff. You can use scrap paper, the kind that I'm sure our shelves are bursting with, or go to Michael's or Hobby Lobby and you get paper packs. I love doing like a start date in here, like an old school calendar almost, and then doing a start date. So you can see it's August 2021 where I did this. And this is really, I tried doing like the mind mapping in here, which again works really great for that. I did kind of drawings like this in here. These are the Fear Street books in kind of an order from R.L. Stein, which I love, 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 love. You can see it's continued and more journaling pages. Ballpoint does great in here. You know, you could do anything and everything basically in here. Outer Banks I put in here, which I heard is coming back and I can't wait. So yeah, so I just did a bunch of things in here, and then I have eating seasonally, you know, just ideas on post-it notes, things like that. So I love using them for this. Now obviously I can continue filling these in. I am not someone who's a stickler for, oh my gosh, it's already used, I won't use it again. I'm not like that. This one I did as like a little meal planner, which I did really enjoy this as well. This was a little bit time consuming to go ahead and write out all of the recipes that I was working on, and then putting groceries on like a little post-it to take. But it is really beneficial. I may make myself do this again, because I feel like this is a great way to kind of go back and not be so lost when it comes to dinner time. Like, I have my kind of go-tos, but going through this now, I kind of really want to force myself to continue this, because then I will maybe get a little more adventurous with meals. I don't know. So I basically kind of set it up to put in the recipes and then grocery lists to follow. So when I meal plan, I would have my grocery list to take with me, and then I would know for the week kind of what I wanted to go with as far as like meal prepping goes. So and then again, you can set it up, oh yeah, that's right, you can set it up however you want to, meaning you can actually Dutch door. If you know how Dutch doors work, what you can do is you can actually cut this page in half, and then you can write out for the week what you want, and then following that week, and then you can like tack your grocery list on there with a post-it. You can actually put in for each of the days and the recipes, or if you don't want to write down the recipes, then you can, you know, save them on a Pinterest board somewhere, whatever. I like seeing it on paper for some reason. I don't know why, but I have like a thing with seeing things on paper. I just like it. And then all I did was highlight each step and each ingredient in a different color. Again, these are things that I really kind of want to go back to. It's why I'm really pulling it out, because I love it. Now this larger size here, this is like a December daily that I played around with in a composition notebook. And I kind of wanted to go back to this again with the composition notebooks, because these are so great to fill for like the season, or for an idea you may have, a project that you know is going to take you a little while. And when I was thinking about fall and Halloween and how I want to tackle it this year, especially with DIYs and decorating and all that kind of fun stuff, I was thinking of dedicating a notebook to it. So here with the December daily, this is a grid notebook. I just wrote that it was a Christmas planner 2022. I utilized the tabs, which I think I will utilize again, because it just makes it easy to find stuff. There are a lot of folks out there that have created planners out of these, which I think, again, is a really, 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 really good idea to do that, because you're not going to be super precious about it. You're really, truly going to be using it as a tool as it's intended to be. You can see I put watercolor on here. I use markers, pens. I did layouts here like you would see, you know, in a weekly spread. I think I also had like space in here to do dailies, and I never ended up doing them in here. Which, looking back on, I kind of wish I did. I did some planning in here, but you can see I broke it down to have my like weeks in here. So it kind of has the concept of a Hobonichi, where you have your vertical and your daily. But what I did, I think, was I put the week and then the day pages to follow, which I kind of like that, rather than having all everything in one section. I know some folks like that. I'm not. These are where all our ideas come for young folks, little ones. Advent calendars, kind of things to, I always do like advent calendars for my kids with different crafts and projects and stuff every year, so kind of planning that out. Here is for tree decorations, things to put on, decorating outside, how to, you know, do all that kind of fun stuff. And it's great to look back on these for, I did create this up in our library. I do have that up there. For the baking, I wish I put in a little bit more, although I don't think I did quite as much this year, because I think we got really sick that year. We've actually gotten sick a couple times around Christmas that has really hindered those like really cute traditions. But I think having something like this as my, not only as a reference for myself, but then for my kids as they get older. So then cards to send, cards to that we've received, you know, that kind of stuff. And then our Christmas card. I usually put our Christmas card anywhere that I'm planning out the holiday. So I do like to keep the Christmas card. I always plan out our photo shoots. I do our photo shoots at home. So I just get a backdrop and I do our photo shoots, but I always like to plan them out. I do the same with Halloween. I do a Halloween photo shoot. This year I kind of want to incorporate the dogs and put them into costumes. So all of that I like to plan out and do in a notebook. So I'm going to dedicate a Halloween one and a fall one. I just need to figure out which size and which one I want to do it with. These are also composition notebooks that I made just into commonplace books. I used acrylic markers, and then here I just used a white gel pen just to decorate, make it really creative and fun. Something that you're drawn to. This kind of follows the whole Linda Berry kind of very busy, lots to kind of look at type of a thing. Again, I put the date, so I think it's really important to put your dates in here. I put a clear pocket with tabs that have those for reference. I do like putting tabs. I do really enjoy that very much. Again, commonplace. I did start numbering a lot of my pages, and that was all I really kind of got in here. So I got the cover, so I'll definitely have to get back into that one. And then I have this commonplace book, which I think I did a little bit more in this one. I think I was just doing the cover for that one, just getting it set up. Another commonplace book. This one, do I have a date on here? I think I let my kids do some stuff in here as well. I let them, because it's all like part of the journey, you know, to let them do work in my stuff too. Stories, I think, writing prompts in here. And you can see I put tabs in there to kind of bring me to these places. So to stay creative, I had a lot of fun doing this. This was, you know, just kind of, again, playing around with different types of art. You can see there's some bleed through because this isn't the best quality. You can always glue two pages together. It just doesn't bother me. I feel like I could always put a post-it on here or draw over it, you know, that kind of a thing. You can see ideas for October Daily, Fall Planners, NaNoWriMo, that's going to be coming up in November, so it's great to kind of get your ideas down. Now, this is what I kind of have changed as far as like me taking notes from books. So I don't any longer take the pages out I just Xeroxed it, but I prefer to just snap a picture of them and keep them digitally versus on the paper. I don't really like doing that anymore. Maybe I will occasionally, but for the most part, this just seems really kind of cumbersome to do it this way. I'd rather have it just digitally. And here I just rather kind of write and stick in other ideas rather than taking in and putting so much paper in here. But you guys can see I've got all different ideas, different kinds of mind mapping or taking notes on stuff. I just really enjoy the whole process of mind mapping. As you can see, I just got a lot of mind mapping. I've done mind mapping videos. Here's one book, 2020, in here. Just putting in different ideas, different drawings, different doodles, going on Pinterest, going on Instagram, doing pros and cons lists. I love doing pros and cons of things. It's really helpful for me to make decisions on stuff. You can see all little doodles, drawings. You know, this is definitely a page from Linda Berry, and I think I have a little tab here that shows that. So I have a Linda Berry tab. This was simply taking a Crayola marker, and this was, I even think this is a exercise that she prompts her students to do, and it's just to draw squiggle lines all around your pages. It's a great like filler page, and I love how it looks. It keeps your head busy, your mind busy. If you're listening to I don't know, you know, if you're sitting in a meeting or you're at a conference, it's a great way to keep your mind kind of focused. You're not scrolling your phone, you know, you're kind of sort of listening, and you know, it's a great exercise. I had a lot of fun drawing this out, and you know, great memories of me trying to work out in the basement and the kids like do karaoke down there and all kinds of stuff. My chickens. So yeah, using like kind of one color and filling in the pages like that. Linda Berry has exercises, I believe, on how to break down your pages so that you don't feel overwhelmed by them. It's all truly inspirational. All of her books, I highly recommend them. Here's another in one color, kind of a page layout. And I really do enjoy those. And looking back on them, it's definitely inspiring, you know. Halloween DIYs. So I guess this is where I'm drawn to the most as far as coming in to do the DIYs. So I have plenty of pages. There's lots to work with. I do really want to turn one of them into a planner for the fall. I just really need to, like, kind of a real craft planner. So truly putting in the ideas, recipes I want to try, you know, really making it like a fall and even into a Halloween one, really breaking down the dates. What I find while doing that is that if you break down the dates more specifically, so if you start off big, so by going down and like starting off big and then breaking down to small is a way to feel less overwhelmed when it comes to any kind of planning, any kind of organizing, is just to start big. And what I mean by starting off big is, let's say for my fall, I'm gonna start with the thing that I love doing the most, and that's decorating. And when I go to decorating, for me, that means I really want, as a wish list, I really want a Halloween fall tree. And if I were to pro and con this, whether or not I want a black tree or a white tree, because I've seen some people do a white tree. And if you do, so let's say we do the Halloween tree and we do a black or a white. Okay. If I do the black, I want orange and purple lights. If I do the white, I'll probably do orange because I feel like it would pop a little bit more. And then this I could use for fall and Halloween. And can I use this for both? That would be the question. So for this, I could use maybe some farmhouse or the gingham color scheme to make that work for fall. This would be easy because it's white. I can even pull it into Christmas time because white is such a neutral color as far as that goes. I could even use it for Valentine's Day, a winter tree. So a lot more holidays with a white tree. So I'm going to turn to Pinterest and I'm going to look on Pinterest and really play around and see and try and compare and sit on that and pull in more of the pros and the cons of doing this. Now you can say this is really silly and maybe it is for you, but I'm just trying to give you examples of how you pull from big and make it small so that you're actually getting it done, making it happen, all that kind of stuff, you know. I've been dreaming about a tree for the fall for quite some time. I've been looking at thrift stores to see if people have gotten rid of them. I've looked on Facebook Marketplace. I've just really kind of been trying to look and scour for the right fall tree to have. I love decorations. You guys know I love the seasonal living. It's super duper important for me, so I love it. As far as the DIYs go, so that usually follows next with and then with the decorating, I don't always go and do the same things in the exact same spots. I change it around. If there is something that I'm like, oh my god, I have to do this again, I'll take a picture of it, print it out, and put it in. Otherwise, I generally just go with where I feel like putting it at that time for that year. I do a lot of thrifting for Halloween decorations. I do a lot of DIYing, like a lot of DIYing. I love it. And those DIYs tend to change. So I'll either repurpose things that I DIY, or I will just donate them or save them for a future project. I do a lot of DIYing. So the DIYs are all kind of under the category for me for decorating. So if I go to the DIY section, and again, I haven't decided how I want to break it down, how I want to split it up, but I'm just kind of sharing ideas for today, how I plan on kind of playing around with this. Decorating DIYs. So I'm going to start with one of the projects I already did, and it is a Dollar Tree one. I love Dollar Tree for these DIYs. It's usually my go-to for it because they tend to have inexpensive supplies, and it makes for a fun project that the kids can kind of partake in as well. So what I did was I went ahead and I got two dollhouses, and I didn't even have to buy any because I usually buy these every time I'm there, because they turn into really good projects for the things that I like to do. So I got the little dollhouses. I got times two of these, and we painted them black. Painted those black. And then I went ahead and I got a black plate from Dollar Tree. A black plate. The two dollhouses, after painting them, I put lights inside. So I put the lights inside. And I just got the orange ones. I have orange and purple, but the kids really like the orange, so I went with the orange. And the orange lights, I'll just color these red, but I'll make a note that they're orange. So the lights go on in the inside, and then I kind of put the two houses together. I glued them together. So lights go inside, and then glue the two houses together. The plate gets glued up on top, and then we decorated the outside. So I put moss from Dollar Tree all around. Dollar Tree has these great little, in the $3 and $5 section, they have they had cute little figurines that were there. I had some extra pumpkins. I picked up extra pumpkins, so I put those around. They have cute little bones that I used to make a little fence. There was a little piece of wood that I stained to use kind of as a base, and I think it all turned out really cute. So you just have to use your imagination. And then on top is a candle. So the inspiration came from the $110 candle holders that they have at Bath and Body Works. And I thought, I need to make this at a way less expensive price because I don't want to spend that much money on it. And so with this, I will have the space where I went ahead and planned it. And now after making it, I definitely want to put a picture for the final product, which I'll post for you guys, or I'll show you guys so you guys can kind of see it. So here's what
it looks like. It's not lit up, so I will show you guys. I hid the battery pack right over here. And so when I turn it on, you guys can see that the lights turn up, and then the candle goes right on top there. So the candle can be lit, and then that's what the piece looks like. So I think, you know, for all Dollar Tree items, it turned out really, really cute. This little piece of wood, again, is really a jack-o'-lantern that you can use for a lot of different stuff, but I just went ahead and stained it and used it as a base. And then these are the two houses that actually weren't the same because there's two different kinds, but I didn't want to buy another one, so I just used the moss to kind of cover that up, cover up the battery pack. There, one of the doors was missing, so I put a little jack-o'-lantern pumpkin. I just drew a face on it. My daughter is great with clay, so she created this little monster. These are the ones that come from Dollar Tree, so you can get a pack of all those cuties from Dollar Tree. Now, if you want a more solid black on the house, you can spray paint it. I just kind of dab paint on there. I was happy with the way that it looked. I actually really like that mottled look of it. There's a pack of bones, so I just glued them together to make it look like there's a front gate. I used clay and wrote Beware on it. These pumpkins are, again, it's all at Dollar Tree. I think that was from last year, but I'm sure they have them again this year. The cat comes in the kit. That also came in a kit. And then the stones, they sell those at Dollar Tree, as well as the moss. So, and then the plate I got also from Dollar Tree. So I think it turned out really, really cute for a very, very inexpensive price. So that's where I'm gonna go ahead and print out a picture and put a picture there so I know how the final DIY turned out. There's another DIY that I want to use. There's a couple, actually, but there's ones that I saw, I think they're at Pottery Barn, where they're all black witches that kind of look like they're sisters following one another. And they all have like the witches' hats on their heads, and they're in all black. So what I was thinking of doing is taking the tomato guards, the ones that you would get at a garden store, and
going ahead and so these are the tomato, you guys know what I'm talking about, those like tomato stands. And then I want to take a I want to zip tie here at the bottom, and I'll put a styrofoam ball on top, and then use a black tablecloth and tie it over. Use pool noodle arms so that they look like arms and connect the witches. So we're gonna use pool noodles. And again, a lot of this you can get at Dollar Tree. So the pool noodles I can get at Dollar Tree. The tomato guards, I'm sure I can get them inexpensively now since we're winding down our seasons. I might even have some extras in the garage. Zip tying here, tablecloths are also the like black vinyl ones are at Dollar Tree. They're around all year. And then the styrofoam ball is probably the one thing I'm going to have to splurge a little bit on to get at Michael's or Hobby Lobby. And then we have to find some hats. Now what I was thinking of doing is putting some solar lights either on the outside or underneath so that they kind of glow. I'm gonna have to test that out, but I was going to do times three of these and put these outside as a fun, which is kind of walking through our front lawn and make it kind of spooky. They sell them, I'm sure, at a better quality on Pottery Barn. I don't want to spend that much money. And then to hold down the bottom here, I'm going to get those hooks and kind of anchor them down into the ground. So when the winds come and it's cold and rainy, hopefully they're staying down. And then I'm going to look into spotlights. So spotlights right now are going to be marked down because they're a summer item. So these are the things I like to think about, have in the back of my mind when I'm going shopping, because I know I want to do this, so I don't wait until October to do it. I'm thinking about it now. I keep it down in my basement until we're ready to kind of bring these things out. But I thought these witches were really, really cute. So I'm going to start with that kind of stuff, and then I'll probably split the section because I won't think of everything all at once, and then move to the back here, use a cute tab, make a cute bookmark. I was thinking of also putting in like cute ribbon and just gluing it here to the back. And then I have like cute ribbons with cute charms on there, and I can add like recipes back here and write down all of my recipes that I kind of want to do and try and kind of have fun with. And so you can see how you can fill up a composition notebook really, really quickly. Or if you're challenging yourself to fill in that one notebook, you can see how you can plan forward. You can fill in your pages with ideas and creativity. They don't always have to be about only memory keeping. Your planner can be for forward planning as well, or your journals are definitely great for that. I'm going to work on this today. It's going to be a fun thing I want to work on today and kind of get going on. So I'll share that with all of you as I get it going. But I wanted to get this out and get you guys inspired. Back to school stuff is out, so go ahead and pick up a stack of your composition notebooks. I do recommend these definitely at Walmart. If you see them, grab them. They did sell out last year. I couldn't find them last year, so when I saw them this year, I grabbed them right away. I'm gonna decorate the covers and make them either holiday inspired. I'm not really sure yet. I'm deciding. I've got scents. I've got, you know, essential oil recipes I want to make for scents. There's all kinds of fun stuff. I want to make some soap. There's so many things I want to get like to crafting on and working on. And all I need is more time. I just need more time because I want to do it all. Thank you guys so much. And I will see you in my next video. Take care. Bye-bye.